When you look on the word hope is a word oftentimes we use it, but we use it out of context. Praise the Lord, God. When you look on the Greek and the Hebrew meaning of hope, hope simply means a confident expectation. Praise the Lord, everybody. Oftentimes, when we use hope, we use it in a doubtful manner. For instance, we think of something and we say, I hope he put out the rubbish, which means we are doubting that he's going to do it. Praise the Lord, everybody. But when you look and doubt and hope in the Bible, praise God, hope, praise God, is different than how we use it today. Hallelujah. When they use hope in the Bible, that they are simply saying, I'm trusting in God. Yeah. I have an expectation, and my expectation is going to come true. That's what else in the Bible. Praise the Lord, everybody. Hope is akin to confidence, a confident expectation. Praise the Lord. It's a trust. Yeah. Praise the Lord, everybody. The difference between the world and the church, our hope is in a different place.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, God. Amen. Feel the Spirit in a little bit. The world, there are two types of hope. There are natural hope and spiritual hope. Praise the Lord, God. Natural hope is based in things that are material. While spiritual hope is based in things that is spiritual. Praise the Lord. Natural hope people believe that if they have a car, everything will be okay. Natural hope people believe if I just will get the degree, everything will be okay. Natural hope people believe that if I can just only get the ring, my life will be better. Praise God, everybody. But do you really understand something? That when you get all of these things, if you don't have spiritual hope, you will still be in problem. Praise God. Paul, praise God, speaks about three virtues that a Christian needs to have. When you read in 1 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse 13, Paul speaks about three biblical virtues. The first one is faith. The second one is hope. And the third one is love. Praise God, everybody. I realize, praise God, that what is happening in the church today is that we are preaching a lot of faith, but not much hope. And God is saying, praise God, what the church needs to preach is not much faith, but it's hope. Because faith without hope is dead. You don't get it yet. If you don't have hope, your skin can't work. If you don't have hope, praise God, your skin is nothing. Skin tries with hope. Because hope is, praise God, an expectation that God is going to do it for us. Oh my God, hallelujah. Just give me, praise God. Faith is, praise God. Hope is the engine, faith driver. So if the engine is not in the car can't move.
Amen.
You can have faith a little bit more. If hope is not it, it is not fear.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
I want to realize that it's happening in the church. There are a lot of people, praise God, they come Sunday morning, they jump, they laugh, they dance, they clap, and they celebrate God. But when they leave Monday morning, they have been who gets next in their life. They magnify God today. And tomorrow they are fretting. We don't say Jamaica platform. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They worship God today. And when they leave tomorrow, they begin to wonder how the bill is going to pay. When you have hope, you don't have doubt. Hallelujah. When you have hope, you have confidence.
Yes.
So even, praise God, the lightning is still. When you have hope, you tonight. But while their companions slept, they were tiring through the night. When you looked at great men in Israel, one thing that they had common is hope. Because if you don't have hope, you can't be great. Praise God. I begin to study some great man of Israel. Yahweh, praise God, is the author of a prisoner of hope. He was saying to us, as a Christian and as a people, we must be so locked up in hope. We must be so shackled with hope. Praise God. Barack Obama, the president of this great country, is the author of the audacity of hope. But everybody said, you will never be the president of this country. Hope was saying to him, yes, I can. Praise the Lord, everybody. When you have hope, praise God. But everybody said, no, it's not going to work. The hope is that, yes, I can. But everybody said, you want to see it. And the strength will never be up to do anything. Hope said, yes, I can. When everybody said, he was going to chant, yes, in your life, the world said, yes, I can. That is hope. Hope, praise God, in Lord. Hallelujah. Nelson Mandela is the author of Long Walk to Freedom. And from freedom to the future. Praise the Lord, everybody. It must be hope that you will lock up a man in prison for over 20 years. And you still are confident that one day you will be free. One day we will be free. One day we will be free. It was hope. When you have hope, regardless of your situation, something is telling you to go on. Martin Luther, before he died, he stood up and said, I have a dream. He's also the author of a testament of hope. What he was really saying, that I have a testimony that hope does work. But everybody said, no, we have to get quiet. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Martin Luther said, no, we have got to get quiet to use this. Because I have a dream that as long as we have expectation in hope, God is going to do it again. Yes. Don't tell me that God is going to do it again. Get in the spirit again. I'd like to teach you. I'd like to bring you to make you understand something. When you look into the Bible, Paul began to write about hope. He said, for whatever was written in early times was written for our instruction, so that true perseverance and encouragement of the scripture, we have hope. Praise the Lord, everybody. He writes to the Corinthian church, and he said, it is in this life only we have hope. In Christ, we are all men. The power of hope. There is something about hope. When a man has hope, praise God, he can achieve it all. Praise the Lord, everybody. And that the church needs to get conscious of. That hope, praise God, that this thing doesn't be a mere title. Praise God, everybody. Our hope is not being on titles or the name of your name. Our hope is built on Jesus Christ. I like the songwriter that put it. He said, my hope is built. I'm nothing less. But I'm Jesus' blood. I'm righteousness. I dare not trust a sweetest grave. But I'm Jesus' name. I'm Christ, the Son of God. Jesus. You're standing on quicksand. If you're not worshiping Jesus, you're not quicksand. Hope. My mind take me back to the Bible. The Bible said now that Peter must understand something about Peter. Peter is a very extraordinary person. The Bible said that Jesus beat Peter. He beat Peter on the sea of Galilee. The Bible said after, hallelujah, Jesus began to talk, hallelujah, to the people. He said to Peter, push out the ship. And show up the net. Peter began to question Jesus. He said, Lord, we've done that before. And you never catch nothing. Jesus said, push out your net. Hallelujah. Do it again. The Bible said that Peter followed instruction. Tell somebody to follow instruction. Hallelujah. Sometimes God taught you, you need to follow instruction. The Bible says Peter followed instruction and do it again. You see, sometimes you need to understand that our circumstances will contrary purpose. But when purpose is in God, give you a purpose. Still stand upon it. Let me take it on. I don't want to show you. All the time you look at the circumstances, if you contradict what God has told you, your circumstances. But never look at the circumstances. Look at the promise that God promised you.
My God.
Peter was looking at the circumstances. But God was saying, don't look at the circumstances. Look at my promise. Show him. The Bible said when he threw out the net that he caught fish, that he could not handle it. He has to call for him. I'm not giving a synopsis of Peter. It was the same Peter when Jesus was in the dark that was with him. The same Peter prayed God in Jesus' name that I'm going to be crucified. Rebuke Jesus. The same Peter that Jesus said, before I die, you are going to deny me. It was the same Peter when Jesus came from the resurrection, Jesus asked where he was. It was the same Peter in Acts chapter 1 and Acts chapter 2 that stand up and declare the gospel.
Yes.
Hallelujah. When you look at the story, the Bible said that Peter was on the ship and he was going out. The Bible said he was a storm. What is a storm?
Storm.
And the storm was so violent that he began to become fearful. The Bible said Jesus was walking on the water. The Bible said when they saw him, they thought it was a ghost. The Holy Ghost beat me here. Because all the times when we are going through hell and hope is coming towards us, we don't look like hope. We look at it like a ghost. We need it to go home, walking on the water, towards us.
Yes.
God, I wish you could get it.
Yes.
Hallelujah, we need to go. Sometimes God will use drunk to feed you.
Yes.
So when you go, we will see the drunk coming.
Yes, Timothy, you heard of me.
So the Bible says, when Peter realizes that it was Jesus walking on the water, Peter said to God, beat me to come.
Yes.
Beat me.
Hallelujah. Jesus said to Peter, come.
My God.
The thing that's supposed to show Peter. It was the thing that he began to walk on.
Yes.
It's when you have hope in Jesus Christ.
Yes.
The thing that's supposed to kill.
Yes.
God will give me the power.
Step.
This.
Yes.
God, God, He gave you the power to step on it. That's why when you come into the presence of God, you need to walk up on Jesus.